So you've got a grand to build a new 1440 PC gaming setup and you don't know where to start? Don't worry, I've got your back. We're diving deep into the world of PC building, picking out the primo parts, slapping them together like a pro, and then unleashing that beast on all your favorite titles. Stick with me and we'll have you dominating the digital battlefield in no time. This is Pure Meta Episode 2. Let's get it. So we're going to start with hardware selection. This is the BOM for the config I have here. So I happen to have all these parts in my inventory. I went online to search for prices and I was able to build this whole thing for about $1,000, and that's including the monitor, mouse, and keyboard. Keep in mind that I looked up prices for used parts. If you're building a rig for about $1,000, I think this is the best route to go. If you want to buy new parts, I don't blame you, but you will probably lose a little performance as compared to this build here. All right, so for the motherboard, I've chosen an MSI B550M Pro. You can find these for about $65 used on eBay, Facebook Marketplace, Craigslist. Dawa's another good used parts resource. For the CPU, I'm going with the AMD Ryzen 5 5600 X3D. Found these for about $200 used. Handling storage, I've got the Kingston NV2 2TB M2 NVMe solid state drive. These are going for about $100 used. Supplying the juice is an EVGA 700BR 80 plus bronze PSU. I've seen these going for about $30 to $40 used at its lowest prices. Pushing the pixels is a PowerColor 6700 XT Hellhound. This is a hell of a card at $240 used. Handling pointing duties is the Pulsar X-Lite V2 Retro, coming in around $40 to $50 used. I've also added some SuperGlide V2 glass gates to this mouse. The iGo A68 wireless mechanical keyboard is the only new component in this build. It's $35 new. Moving on to the actual build process. First step is to install the CPU into the motherboard and snap it into place. Next, we're going to install the CPU cooler. I've got a Deepcool AG400BK here. I'm going to place the backplate onto the motherboard and then insert these spacers. Then I will fasten two of the screws first. And then place the bracket onto the spacers. And then we're going to go ahead and fasten the rest of the screws down. Place the cooler onto the mount and then fasten that down. Next, we're gonna install the RAM. Gonna place these two initially into place and then snap them down. Step four, I'm gonna take my Kingston NV2 and insert it into the M2 slot on the motherboard. Next, we're gonna install the IO shield onto the case. Next, I'm gonna install the PSU. Most cases have a certain orientation the PSU needs to be in. Just make sure you check the fastener placement before you start doing this step. All right, now we're gonna fasten the motherboard to the case. Make sure you place it onto the corresponding mounting positions. Once you've done so, use the included screws with your case to fasten it down. The next step is to fasten the case fans. I'm using a 5600X3D here, which keeps temps pretty low. So I'm only using one case fan here. I don't need any crazy intake setup. This also helps to keep the cost low. Next, we're gonna connect the fan and RGB cables to the motherboard headers. You'll notice my GPU is connected here, but I actually did this out of order. So do as I say and not as I do here, or you're probably gonna run into issues. Next, the case has some cables for the USB audio output and front panel. We're going to connect these cables to the corresponding motherboard headers. Again, make sure your GPU is not in for this step, or else you're going to have some trouble. This is the header key if you have loose jumpers for the front panel cables. After you've connected all those cables, now we can install the GPU. So we're going to take off this rear cover. Go ahead and install the GPU. It's gonna have to go over this RGB cable if you wanna have lights on your cooler. When you place your GPU, you should hear an audible click when it's fully seated, like so. Next, you're gonna fasten the GPU to the case bracket. If you have a heavier card, then it helps to hold it in place while you do this. We are already almost done. Next, we're gonna route the power cables. So first is the ATX 24 pin cable. gonna route it through up here. Next is the EPS CPU cables, gonna route it through this hole up here in the top right. And then the VGA PCIe connectors for the GPU. There is a hole in the bottom that gives easy access to the connectors here. I'll tuck away the rest of the cables underneath. First, I'll connect the ATX 24 pin cable to power the motherboard. Step 14, we're gonna power the GPU through the PCIe cables. This one is daisy chained and that will be fine for a card like this. To feed power to the CPU, we're gonna connect the 8-pin EPS cable in the upper left corner of the motherboard. And we're pretty much done putting this thing together. So we'll start closing it up. Pay attention to these mounting points and close the rear panel. The Li&Li LandCool 205 has thumb screws to fasten these panels. Next, I'm gonna attach the front cover. This one just snaps into place, as you'll see. Next, I'm gonna attach the side glass panel. Again, pay attention to these mounting points when you put it into place. Place it carefully and then use the thumb screws to fasten it down. After you do that, you can connect your monitor, make sure it's powered up, and then connect an HDMI or a DisplayPort cable. Take a second to admire your creation and then go ahead and boot it up. All right, so now that we've put together the machine, we need to install Windows. To create a bootable USB drive, you're gonna go to this website here, download this tool, and then install the tool onto a USB drive. If you don't have access to another machine, maybe have a friend create it for you. You'll need a USB drive, preferably 16 gigabytes or lower. Usually the larger ones can have issues, so I tend to use smaller ones. Insert the USB, then mash the delete key when you boot it up. Go over to the boot menu and boot from the USB drive. It will take you into the Windows installation application. Go ahead and select the version that you want. I'm gonna go with Windows 11 Pro here. If you have your key handy, go ahead and enter it now. If you don't, you can enter it later. Just say, I don't have a key. Like I said, I'm selecting Windows 11 Pro. Select your blank drive and then proceed forward. Let it do its thing. I usually go and do something else while this completes. And when it's all done, it will take you into the Windows welcome screen. And you'll need to go through an initial setup. The first thing I do here is hit Shift F10 and then type in OOBE/bypass NRO. Windows annoyingly makes you sign into a Microsoft account to install Windows. If you type in this command, you can bypass that step. So your machine should start back up and then the screen will look the same, except when you get to the internet connection screen, there will be an option that says continue with limited setup. This will allow you to proceed with a local account rather than having to sign in with the Microsoft account online. Go ahead and type in your desired username and finish the initial setup. I prefer to disable all these live services. They are always just running in the background and transmitting your info. First thing I'm going to do once we boot up into Windows is hit the start key and start typing in update Windows. You'll get to the settings screen. Go ahead and download all the available updates. You'll likely have to restart after the first round. Go back into the Windows update screen after it restarts and run the next round and repeat this until no more updates populate for you. Next, I'm gonna update the BIOS on my MSI B550M Pro. I just usually Google the motherboard name and go to the official website from the manufacturer. Here is the update for my board. The link is down below. For this board, I just need to transfer the BIOS file onto a USB drive, boot into the BIOS, and then use the BIOS updater tool. Once that's completed, go ahead and boot back into the BIOS so that we can configure the settings here. For this configuration, I'm going to enable Combo Strike 3, which is equivalent to setting a PBO undervolt of minus 30. Then I'm going to enable the XMP profile on these sticks. This will set the memory to 3600 CL16. Then I'll set the U clock to match the memory clock and the F clock to do so as well. So I'll set it to 1800 megahertz. For this version of the BIOS, resizable bar is already enabled by default. So I'll go ahead and boot back into Windows. So now our Windows is updated, the BIOS is updated. First thing I do is download Google Chrome because I cannot stand Microsoft Edge. You have to go through all these prompts that try to get you to sign in. Go to google.com/chrome, download the browser and install it. Next, I like to debloat my taskbar by disabling most of the default options that show up there. And then I like to set my preferred background and theme. I usually like to go with the dark color scheme over the light one. Once the Chrome install is completed, I like to set it as my default browser. Again, Microsoft tries to force Edge on you as much as possible. You have to go and set Chrome as a default for each file extension type, whereas before they used to just let you do it in one click. Now you have to do a bunch of them. If you're a gamer, then I suggest you also go into your mouse settings and disable enhance pointer precision. This adds an acceleration algorithm to your mouse movement, and I find this is not ideal for gaming. Moving on, we're going to install the GPU drivers now. I have a 6700 XT Hellhound, so I just usually Google the name of the card and go to the official website for AMD to download the latest Radeon drivers. Right now it's 24.3.1. So just go ahead and follow the prompts and wait for that to complete. All right, folks, buckle up because we've got benchmarks for 10 of today's hottest gaming titles lined up. If you want to lend a hand to the channel, go ahead and watch each benchmark from start to finish to help boost that algorithm. Otherwise, feel free to utilize the timestamps below to jump straight to the titles you're itching to see. If you found this content helpful, informative, or entertaining, please consider giving the video a thumbs up and subscribing to Pureology so you don't miss any future uploads. As always, I appreciate you investing your valuable time here as I pursue my dream of creating content full time. I couldn't do it without your support, so from the bottom of my heart, thank you. Alright, that's all for now. Enjoy the benchmarks, it's back to the grind for me, and I hope to catch you in the next one. Peace.
City, welcome back. My guest tonight is Lieutenant Sarah Kokoski, spokeswoman for the NCPD. Hi there. Welcome to the show.
Hello, Ziggy. Thanks for having me.
Thank you. arrived at your destination. Afraid? You're the little sod that saved Treadwell.
Incendio.
You may run.
Huh? Levioso. Incendio.
This isn't a pet.
Depulsor. Confringo. Lumos. Incendio. Leviosa. Expelliarmus. Incendio. Accio. Incendio. Leviosa. Expelliarmus. Lumos. Leviosa. Incendio. Expelliarmus. Accio. Incendio. Thank you.
for teaching students jinxes. Next thing you know, it's unforgivable curses. Practices of the dark arts should stick to fighting. Wingardium Levium.
Expelliarmus, Levioso, Incendio, Accio.
Democracy! Objective located.
I'm on the terminal.
Objective located. North.
On my way. Engaging. I'll take it. Dropping package.
I'm on the terminal. I'll handle the terminal.
Dropping a pin. East. Far. Supplies!
Thank you.
Calling down a sentry! Calling in reinforcements! Objective located.
I'm on the terminal.
Sentry.
Restrictions.
Meters.
Heard that! Calling in reinforcements!
Tagging map, south, 100 meters. Ending in an eagle. Dropping a pin, northwest, 100 meters. Weapon.
status 30 seconds. Request approved. Reinforcements have been launched. ETA T-minus 20 seconds.
I got him. Oh, another one across. He hit my claymore. Oh, shit. Yeah. Chris, I'm playing on a $1,000 build right now that I made. Yep. No, 11,000. Jeez. 1,000 total everything. Yeah. People drop into control. Actually, I think they're pulling up. Grabbing a key card. Somebody's dropping in. Where are you? Four. Let's go. Somebody just dropped in behind two. We can get Lodi. I have a card. Oh shit, never mind. There's a guy on two on roof. Fuck. Yeah, he is mounted with the choreo. I'm gonna grab my guns. Two boxes here. It's probably them. Get off me. I just killed one of their guys on Lodi. Oh shit, behind me. Somebody's shooting me from, I don't know where. Plates. Good, yeah. In the corner. Yeah, it keeps coming back, dude. Dropping now. They're hitting me. One of them dropped down to the buy. Yeah, they are. I'm going back to green. Oh my god, they're still hitting me. Well, it's fire cell. Control it. I was getting hit from everywhere. Yeah, I'm on control. No. Yo, oh my God, it's fucking picking up. Plate box. I'm okay, I think. No, I'm good. I have 8K actually. I can buy a UA. If we get a buy. That's it already? Oh shit, there's people right above. All down low, over here. On two, they're coming up. They're coming up from two. I'm dead. Damn, I didn't know you could jump the fence. Nice.
Yeah, the tower needs love. The tower needs
Как подствольник юзать?
Играешь в там, где у тебя оружие, понял? Yeah. Может быть, где-то для гранат должен
быть. Еботы!
Let me see how good it is. Oh yeah, look at that shit!
We could use some sort of MG on this.
that vehicle and load it up for me? Audrey? Yeah, can you bring it to, my mark over here at G6?
Yeah, copy that.
What do you want in it? Half and half or mostly ammo? Mostly ammo, let's get just do.
Yeah.
bot. Go see more.